Yeah, my name's Shannon Rademacher from Grabby Oz Bike Co, based here at MtBuller, northeast Victoria. Yeah, Drift Bike Tour has been going for, this is our third year. It's been great to have you guys down here again. And it's always a blast, Everyone's, pretty chilled, pretty excited, loves riding and they're passionate.
The tour's really started to pick up momentum and interest from afar. But I think the reason behind that as well is the fact that Buller as a trail network is currently the number one destination in Australia. Forget about cooking. Forget about cleaning. You don't even have to make your bed. You don't even have to look after your bike. You just wake up each day and you go riding. That's it.
So my name's Rylan, I'm from Wollongong. I've joined Drift on the 2015 Mount Buller Tour. I heard about the tour through the Drift Bikes family email and couldn't miss the opportunity.
So for the last 6 months, I've been riding, training pretty hard to make sure I'm ready for the ride. And and in February, it was time to head down with the guys. You realise that you're in for some good riding. That mountain just keeps going and going, and that's driving up in the car. And you get to the top. It's a bit of a surreal experience, like a ski town in summertime with no one around and all these beautiful mountains for miles and miles to see. And then you rock up at the ski chalet where we get to stay, and I knew I was in for a good week.
Day one started with just a good lap of the famous Stonefly, then with a massive descent to the Deltoite River Trail.
It was just some of the fastest riding I've ever done, just trying to hang on, but also riding within my limits, but just having the best time, just knowing that you're riding on some of the best trails in Australia.
It was a tough trail. First section's very steep and rocky, pretty fast, and you sort of got to hang on. And then once you get into that flowy section, a single track, beautiful scenery. It's a good ride. Yeah, refreshing.
I think sometimes the best riding you do is when you've never ridden a trail before. You're not knowing what's around the next corner. If you knew it was there, you maybe not have hit it at the speeds and handled it as well as you do. You're just drifting around corners, avoiding fallen trees, snakes on the trails, and then get to the bottom and you, I don't know how many bridge crossings over the river there were.
The the reason MtBuller is an annual destination for the drift bikes on tour and its riders is because it just has a massive amount of different trails. Even though, you know, MtBuller, like the common saying is, there, you know, it's either up or down, there's no in between, that's not a bad thing. Like, but it's also the way in which those trails are made, you know, around that terrain, which gives it so many different trails.
Not a person to be seen, not a house to be seen, just endless mountains and endless possibilities. And so, yeah, you just didn't know where on that mountain you were going to end up by the end of the week.
Definitely takes the stress out of every day, and also helps reduce the cost of going away, is we have our own in-house chef. Dylan started out as a customer of ours, ended up really good riding buddy, and he does an amazing job. Like, he'll come away and he's right there preparing everything, breakfast, lunch, dinner, and it just, you're not thinking about where your next meal's coming from.
Make sure everyone's well fed, high in nutrition, whatnot. Need to keep that energy up each day. That's about it.
Not having to eat out every night is also a massive pleasure, because you're just always in the comfort of the lodge and stress-free, and just pretty much reflect on the rest of the day just gone and talk about what you're going to do the next day.
Had our gear packed, ready to go for that night of camping, and had the guys take up all our gear, our bikes, our clothes, the camping gear, and everything was set up for us. Bikes were checked once again, and the chef was there. He cooked our meals as we sat around the campfire listening to camp stories of wild dogs and crazy hunters, stocking up our reserves for a run down the epic descent.
Definitely this year has been a sign of probably a bigger step of growth due to the Epic Trail and the launch. And certainly I think that Epic launch has put Buller on a bigger pedestal as a destination place to ride.
We embarked on the Australian Alpine Epic, a 42k loop around the ridges of Mount Buller and Mount Stirling.
Starts off like some of the other trails you've been doing earlier in the week, but then it gets into the side of the mountain, which is the best berms, corners, little rock drops, log crossings, loose baby head rocks, and you're thinking, your brakes are howling, you're thinking to yourself, how much more can this go on?
42 kilometres of trail with the last quarter of it being descending is amazing.
Biggest thing that I think people are finding after hearing about the Epic is they think that 42k is easily doable. Certainly in the Alpine environment, it's pretty much, you could look at it times two, and anything that you do on the flat on 40k's, it pretty much could double it in the Alpine as far as how tough it can be. So, you know, even though there's 1600 metres of descending over 42k's, but that's doubled in climbing, so you can pretty much match that.
the climb that was 500 metres but turned into a kilometre and a half, that one.
Yeah, that
was the worst part of it, I reckon. it was just that teaser, like it was just like, yeah, you're almost there, but you had to put in the effort to get to it.
Yeah.
But yeah, so once you hit the top, once you knew there was no more climbing, it was just magic. Yeah.
since she did on the hand. She'll always lick it down when she knows that she can. Well, like a S-A-A-T, my baby saved me, then played me and jammed in the sand. Well, like a S-A, she tried to correct me. She meant to protect me, but only betrayed me. Now, you're too proud to call, guess I never knew. Snow back to the favelas, I'm magnanimous. That's just good, only for the sake of posterity. It's unanimous, I'm a star. 4 days in the cells of the day. Now, you're too proud to call, guess I never knew. The problems, Jennifer Bennett's here. I swear she's not the same person I grew up with. She's not the same person I left.
Suffering, a lot of sweat, you know, a lot of dirt and dust, and certainly crossing that line at the end was awesome to see everyone just totally stoked on finishing and accomplishing such a ride.
The hardest part about coming home from a MtBuller trip is that you're going to re-enter your old trails, well, with a lot more skills, but probably realise that you've, in the same process, you've dulled them down considerably. But that's what keeps you hungry to, you know, go to another destination or get back to MtBuller.
And I'd just like to say thanks to the guys from Drift for organising. It was one of the best holidays I've ever had.